Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how to sublimate a notebook. Yes, you heard me. We're going to sublimate a notebook. There's actually notebooks on the market that are made for sublimation. So I'm actually going to show you guys how to do this front and back with your Cricut Easypress. So let's go ahead and get started. So for today's project, we are going to be sublimating a notebook that is made for sublimation. You can get these from wherever you purchase your blanks from. There is all sorts of dealers out there. And then I have already printed out my design. I printed out front and back. I designed this in Creative Studio and used my Sawgrass printer. And I did this on 11 by 17. So I'm going to go ahead and just cut these in half. And then I am going to prep everything up. So I've got my Cricut pad as well as my Cricut 9x9. You could do your heat press as well. I've got a piece of parchment paper down on the bottom. I'm going to put my notebook, and then I'm going to go ahead and trim down each piece of my printed design. So I'm going to go ahead and trim as close as I can. This is just going to help me line it up on top of the notebook and make sure that I've got it exactly where I want it. If I have the excess paper, I can't really tell where I'm going since I'm having to put this upside down. So you're kind of going in blind. Now, with this particular product, I didn't use any adhesive spray. I didn't use any tape or anything. I just placed it down. So make sure that you guys are super careful not to shift it. So once you have your design where you want it, you are ready to apply your next piece of parchment paper to protect it from the heat press. I'm using my 9x9 iron today. This perfectly fit on top of this notebook. Once again, you could definitely use your heat press for this project. I'm doing 385 for 40 seconds. And so once we've got that done, I'm going to go ahead and lift up that iron, move it out of the way, and then we will also remove the piece of parchment paper. So you want to go ahead and remove this as quickly as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and get this without shifting it and peel it right up. Look at how good that looks. I love how bright and vibrant these colors are. It's just a ton of fun. The possibilities are endless when it comes to sublimation, and this just shows it once again, all the cool things you can do. Now you can see how my papers are bowed. We're gonna work on that after we sublimate the other side. If you're only doing one side, you would wanna do what we're gonna do at the end now. So like I said, we'll touch that here in just a second. So let's go ahead and trim away the excess on our next piece of sublimated paper. Now, one thing that I like to do when I'm doing full bleeds like this, I like to dry my papers for a few seconds. So I just hovered my heat press. You could do your heat press or your easy press. I use my easy press just to hover it over it. That will really help you with these full bleeds when you're having to handle them. So now I'm just going to line this up once again. I can kind of fill around the edges to make sure I'm nice and even. I'm going to apply my piece of parchment paper again and then set my heat press on top and press 385 for 40 seconds once again. So I'm just going to hold that and keep consistent pressure. So there we have it. So we're going to move our iron again and pull off that parchment paper. And now this time we're going to go ahead and peel that design up, but this time we're going to go ahead and apply the pressure. So I'm going to go ahead and show you really quick. You've got the back and the front. You could do a total different design. So I made this one like a full wrap. So it looked like it wrapped all the way around it. So now what you're going to do is take something heavy. Now I told you, make sure you put the parchment paper in between. I didn't do that here, but I definitely, as soon as I cut the camera, I actually decided to. So I removed everything, put the parchment paper, and then put the boxes. This is a box of mugs. So it's just heavy. I'm just finding anything in my craft space that's heavy, but you could do books or whatever you'd like. Once you're done, you're going to remove those and you're going to notice that it's no longer bowed. So you just need to apply that heat to get it back down to normal, just like that. So don't freak out when you first press these and you're like, oh my gosh, it's ruined. It's totally not. So just like that, we made our very own notebook.
So how much fun is this? We can sublimate our own notebooks. You could do these for planners, whatever you would like, back to school. If you guys are in college or somebody's graduating this year and you want to make them some college gifts, you could definitely do that. You could do your business logo, all sorts of things. So there is notebooks on the market that you can sublimate. Now I have seen people buy them from the Dollar Tree and do those as well. So for example, if you sublimate on glitter cardstock, white glitter cardstock, you could definitely do that as well. But this is definitely something that is out there on the market, and I'm really excited to show you guys this. As you guys seen in the video, I just applied pressure, so you could take a stack of books if you wanted to. You just want to stack those on top, put something in between them for one to protect the heat from the books or whatever you're putting on top, as well as scuffing up your notebook. So you definitely want to do that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.